Students, in this video we will be looking at the third tense, present perfect tense. If you are new to our channel, please subscribe our channel and leave your comment in the comment box. Okay, look at the title, present perfect tense. So far we have seen simple present tense and the present continuous tense. This is the third tense. What is the form of the verb of present perfect tense? Remember, my dear students, for each and every tense, you need to remember three things. Number one, the form of the verb or the structure of the verb. Number two, the usage or the time of action. And number three, the time indicators which are used with the tense. Okay, first one is form of the verb. The structure or the form of the verb of present perfect tense is subject plus have or has plus V3 plus object. Here, have or has, we have two words, have or has. These two are called have forms. Have, has and had are called have forms. Here we can call them auxiliary verbs or helping verbs because there is a main verb. These verbs help the main verb, so they are called helping verbs or auxiliary verbs. Next, V3. Verb has three forms. Present verb, past verb, past participle verb. Okay, generally, instead of saying present verb and past participle verb, for the convenience of the students, the teachers introduce the three kinds of verbs, three names of the verbs like V1, V2, V3. Whenever I say V1, that is present verb. Whenever I say V2, that is a past verb. Whenever I use V3, that is a past participle. Remember. Next, object. In each tense, subject and object are common, but this is very important. Okay, we have two words, have, has. Okay, with what subjects have is used and when has is used. You look at this. For the subjects, I, we, you, they, have is used. I have, we have, you have, they have. For the third person singulars, in the simple present tense, I have introduced these three. He, she, it are called third person singulars. So, with the third person singulars, has is used. And when the proper noun is used as the subject of a sentence, then also has is used. For example, Raju, Raju has. Lakshmi, Lakshmi has. But when two proper nouns are used, Raju and Lakshmi, they are treated as plural. So it takes have. This is about have and has when they are used. Next, coming to the most important part, that is time of action or the usage. When do we use this present perfect tense? Look at this usage. This is the first usage and very, very important usage. If you understand this usage, you can answer the questions in examination and you can speak grammatically exact sentences and the accurate sentences. So, what is the first usage? Present perfect tense is used to express just completed actions or actions completed a short while ago or actions completed a little while ago. We know actions completed. Generally, when an action completed, it is understood that it is a past action. Okay, but this is a completed action, but this action was completed a little while ago or a short while ago. Remember this clue word, a short while ago or a little while ago. When you hear the word a short while ago or a little while ago, you remember that the time gap between the occurrence of the action and the present point is very, very little time. So, look at this. It is called immediate past action. If you look at this diagram, you can understand the right usage of present perfect tense. See, I have drawn two lines here. So, black line, this is past time. and the red line, this is a future time. Okay, past time means the time that passed. Future time means the time that is to come or yet to come. So in between these two, blue dot is there. This blue dot is the present time where we are. The present point of time where I am talking about this present perfect tense. So imagine, here is a, look at this dot, black dot. Imagine at this point, action completed. Imagine at this point action completed. You see between the between the black dot and the blue dot there is a little space. What is it called? Time gap. So between these two points the time gap is a very short time, very little time. So whenever we talk about actions which completed a short while ago, a little while ago, they are called immediate past actions. So those immediate past actions are used in present perfect tense. Okay, present perfect tense is a past action, but it is not a long past. But this action was finished, was completed a short while ago or a little while ago. So in other words, you can say the time gap between the occurrence of the action and at the present moment is very, very little. So present perfect tense is used. Okay, I give you an example. For example, we have attended a function. When we attend a function, known people or relatives or acquaintances, when they see us, they ask a question, when did you come here? When did you come here? So the answer varies from person to person. Some people give the answer in simple past tense, I came here last night. Some people give the answer in present continuous tense, I am coming now. And some people give the answer in present perfect. What is that answer? I have just come here. We have just come here. So to give the answer for the immediate past action or the actions completed a short while ago or a little while ago, this present perfect tense is used. If you look at this diagram, you can categorically understand the exact usage of present perfect tense. Okay, generally, these are the words which are used in present perfect tense. These are the time indicators. Okay, in examinations, in 10th class examination or intermediate examination or degree examination, in competitive examination, in any board examination, if there are questions on this tense, you try to find these words. These are the time indicators used with present perfect tense. So remember these. Okay, examples. First example, my father has just stepped out. If somebody asks you, is your father at home? Then your answer may be, my father has just stepped out. So, occurrence of the action is a little while ago, a short while ago. So, what is the tense used? Present perfect tense. In this example, what is the time indicator? Just. Okay. Second example, I have come here just now. Okay. Just now, I have given you an example. When the people ask you, when did you come here? When did you come here, then this your answer is, I have come here just now, means not long ago, not a long time ago. Next, third example, she has already paid the examination fee. So this is also present perfect tense. Fourth one, so far I have read two novels. So far means by this time. Okay, by a specific point of time at present moment. Okay, I have read two novels. Okay, fifth example, the train has not arrived yet. For example, the train's scheduled time is 5 p.m. You reach the station at 4:45 and since 4:45 you have been waiting for the train. Okay, now the time is 5:30. Your friends come to the station and on seeing you, they ask a question. Okay, why are you still waiting? Then your answer is, the train has not arrived yet, even at 5:30 p.m. So this is generally used, this yet is generally used in negative sentences. Whenever we want to give the answer in a negative sense, this yet time indicator is used. Okay, next another example. Have you ever seen the Red Fort? Okay, you can ask, you can also ask an interrogative sentences, that is using the same structure, but generally this is a time indicator used. Have you ever seen the Taj Mahal? Have you ever seen the Red Fort? Have you ever seen the Golconda? Okay, you can ask such questions. Okay, sometimes we give positive answer, sometimes we give negative answer. To give negative answer, what is the word used? Never is used. I have never seen Taj Mahal. This is about actions which were completed a short while ago or a little while ago. Next, number two. Present perfect tense is used to express past actions with no specific point of time. Generally, to express past actions, we need to use past time indicator. Without a past time indicator or expression, simple past tense can never be used. It is grammatically wrong. So, we can use present perfect tense to talk about past actions with no specific point of time. See, we have got independence. Actually, this is present perfect tense. This is a past action. We got independence in 1947. Everybody knows. But here, in 1947 is not given. But I am using present perfect tense to talk about a completed action or a past action without a specific point of time. So, if you want to use simple past tense, you can use with time indicator. Okay, without using the time indicator, you can use present perfect tense to talk about a past action. That is the point here you need to remember. Second one, she has seen the film Gandhi. Actually, this is also a completed action, but at what point of time the action was completed is not mentioned, not specified. That is why present perfect tense is used. Remember, present perfect tense is also used to express past actions with no specific point of time. Next, third usage. Present perfect tense is used to express an action which began in the past. Remember, action began in the past and the same action has continued up to the present moment. Okay, imagine an action started some time ago in the past and the same action is continued. The action is continued up to the present moment. At the present moment, it is still in progress. That is understood. For example, I have lived in Delhi for 10 years. That means I started living in Delhi 10 years ago and now I am still living in Delhi. So far 10 years completed. That is the meaning. Second example, I have worked for a firm for 5 years. Okay, I started working in a firm, in an organization 5 years ago. And at the time of speaking, now I am still working for the same firm. That is the meaning. Okay, third uses, an action which began in the past and which has continued up to the present moment. Okay, next, fourth usage is, present perfect tense is also used to talk about resultative past actions. Resultative past action is also called the evidential use of present perfect tense. Okay, what is this resultative past? What is the evidential use of present perfect tense? For example, we are coming from Delhi. Okay, when we started in Delhi, there was no rain. When we reach our destination and there is water everywhere, water is stagnated on either side of the road, then we see the scene and we say it has rained. We make the statement, it has rained. Why? How can we say? Evidence is, look, the ground is wet. The ground is wet and the water is seen on either side of the road, you know. And second example, the thieves have entered the house. For example, a family went out to attend a party or a function at a far place. After 2 days, they got back. Okay, when they got back home, okay, by the time they reached home, the door was opened and the things were seen helter-skelter. So then family members came to the conclusion that the thieves have entered the house. What is the evidence to say that it was the work of the thieves? The door was opened and the door was broken, window panes were broken and the things were thrown helter-skelter. So this is the evidence. So we can say this is a resultative past. So these are the important usage of present perfect tense we can use in our written language and spoken language. Okay, this is all about present perfect tense. Please subscribe our channel English Victor. Thank you.